Hey, every time these things start, I wonder if they're really on. Is this thing on? Guitar. I wonder if you can hear it. The microphone down here. I muted it. That's no good. In Pennsylvania today, there's the lottery, $1 billion, and they're asking people in line, what are you going to do if you hit? People have all kind of answers. Well, I'm gonna, me, if I hit $1 billion, I'm gonna keep working until the money runs out. Playing jazz, man. Whole tone scale in thirds. Mundelland, San Diego. You know, sometimes I'll find chords by just moving a note just to see what happens. Like that. I'll just move the bottom note just to try it. I like that. I meant to play this one time. B7 with a flat 5, see? Instead, I did this. It was a mistake. Then I kept doing it because I liked it. Glasgow, wow. You know, somebody asked me about a low D tuning. And, you know, you mentioned Mundell Low. And I did get to hang out with him in Wales and other places. He always tuned that low E to a D. Let me show you what it does. I'm prepared today. Hang on. Let's see. What do we got going here? I think it's... Let's see. I should get these a little sharp. So now what you have is two D strings. So now your octaves are like this, look. Hard to get that in tune. Anyway, it's kind of like, okay, so your G7th that looks like this now is here. Now my A minor 7 is now like this. Whatever you usually play on the low E string is up 2 frets, even single notes. So, Intro, let's see. So D9. The only problem is that you kind of get stuck into playing a lot of things in D. You tend to overuse it. Well, I do anyway. It's a poor man's 7-string guitar. C major 7 is now like this. C7 with a flat 5. F. Is it an F? No, not an F, see? Here we go. Okay. G minor. The bridge of which gets hard. The other thing is good. Well, let's see. Where did it go? I like to get that G flat down here, but now look. Yeah, bass line, sure. There we go. F, 251 key of F, G minor. See, is that right? Too hard. You'd have to always play the guitar like that to really get good at it. I got that Jimmy Bruno model back the other day. Bill Cummins, as busy as he is, managed to find time to make a new nut down there. He showed me a guitar that he's going to have at the Woodstock Guitar Show. It's a 6-string, 16-inch guitar. It's blonde. It has a pickup here. And it has a piezo pickup on the bridge. So if you have an amp that has two inputs like the Hendrickson does, it works out great. It's a stereo cord here. And on the other end, you have two outputs. So one goes in one channel and the other goes in the other channel. And you can mix them up. So it's kind of really cool. Wish I had that guitar. And it's Clark top. Clark guitar. Much easier with a 6-string for me. I have the heat on here too. It's a little too hot. So the lotteries, the Pennsylvania lottery, is on $1 billion. You're asking people what they would do. I'm gonna keep playing jazz till I run out of money. What's this here? 4 to 7 string. an E flat walking bass. Yeah, you can. An E flat to D. Sure, you can get a low E flat. It would be here. And it's kind of cool, but it kind of messes up a lot of other things. At least for me. Hey, Philly, there's only 11 shootings last night. Things are looking up. A couple announcements. That part two of that video interview by Dr. Seth Greenberg is up somewhere. Tomorrow I'll post the links. There's part two of that is up. Also, gigs for next year come. We're going to be at the Iridium. I'll tell you when. The tickets already are on sale. Let me see if you can find it. I got to go to next year. It's February 18th, 2019. So things are coming up nicely. I'm still waiting to hear from the True Fire guys to do a instructional video. So, any ideas that you might have you would like me to see to do for instructional stuff, shoot me an email. Some guy got a little bent and I didn't say fuck enough. Yeah, I pissed off at myself too. You know, so fuck, 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 and fuck. There's also, I liked it, had an old friend that, Iridium, very cool, good place. Played there a lot before. Guys that use the word fuck so much that they put the word fuck inside a word. Like, hey, Bob, what are you going to do after the show? Well, I'm just going to go back to the mo fucking tell. Always commercial of the arts in Philadelphia. You should see what they think is art. Sometimes it's really good, but most of the time. I call it, it's the farts in Philadelphia. A lot of great people that live there. The city kind of has a life of its own. It's dead, but don't know it yet. Here. I'm playing over a 2-5, solo over in 2-5-1. Here, let's see. So what you got is a bar of this. G7, C major, C6. I left out the turnaround to it, which goes. So I'm going to do it without the turnaround. Let's see. I'm just going to play these notes. Outside notes. Here comes F sharp. Again, F sharp. Wow. Rhythm section's on a break. Let me do it again. You don't have to play the whole scale either. Look, I just play a couple notes. I'm at 170. CBA. I added a G. What if I start on different beats? One, let a whole bar go by. Different beats of the two chord. One, two. Let's change the tempo. Let's make it slower. Let's go down to 90. It's harder to play slower. Watch. That F sharp really sticks out now. Faster. Let's see, tempo. Here's 255. What happened? Here we go, let's try it again. Rhythm section. See if I can double time that. No, I guess not. Come on. Bullshit guitar. All right, so still gotta figure out what this means. Messages held for review. Somebody take their balls out? What the hell does that mean? Tomorrow I'll bring out that Jimmy Bruno model Sadowski guitar. Busy as this guy, Bill Cummins, is, he found time to fix it for me. It's like a new guitar, you know, and you get a really good luthier, repair guy. You know, I don't know what, you know. Bill's a maker. Started out repairing guitars. I think most of those guys did. Don't really know that tune. There's a great recording of Art Tatum playing that solo piano. Just chorusing. Jeez, forever. And there's a guy in the background listening to him banging a newspaper on 2 and 4. It's just incredible. It's just, I'm pretty sure that's the tune. Got nothing to say, so I was, fuck it. Fuck it. What do you do? Fuck it. All right, so C for two. The thing I did earlier was this. Not really. C for two is D minor, G7, D minor, 7, C major. There's another part to the tune, but I don't know what it is. It's more like Sandow. Chord melody idea. That's what I was thinking. For Two Fire. What about Foot on the Bottom? Right hand technique. Hold the lighter and do it. I like the bridge. I had students one time watch me play, and I see them in the hallway, like practicing with a lighter in their hand. You dumb bastard, don't do it like that. When I was at University of Arts, boy, what used to drive me nuts was the class was at 2 o'clock. I think my improv class was at 2 o'clock. Yeah, guy come two, you know, 2:05, that's okay. You know, but the guy that comes 2:15, class already started, and he's their first guy. Hey, what do you mean by that? Well, you dumb son of a bitch. This is what I'm thinking. I didn't say it to him, but I want to say, listen, you dumb jerk off. Now I have to repeat the whole 15 minutes of the class so you could catch up so I can bore the rest of the class. Dumb bastard groove. All right. I'll see you tomorrow regular way. And I'm going to leave it at that. See you later. Bye. Travis style. I don't even know what it is, and I don't even know what classical style is. Maybe call it Joe Pass. Classical, I said. See, I don't think they're any different. They're playing fingers, you know? It gets too complicated. Too many names, too many different styles. Trudy Pitts, is that what you're talking about? Trudy Pitts, yeah, Miss Trudy a lot. Trudy Pitts and Mr. C. When I first moved back here from L.A., Mr. C got me working in Philly, Mr. C, and I got to play with Trudy many, many times, which is really a cool thing because she played on Pat Martino's first record, El Hombre. Merrill Travis, I don't know who that is. Billy Bauer, I know. Yeah, my. I know. Hard to. I don't like hillbilly music. I don't know what that means either. If the guy can, you know, that bad, that, if you mean like, you know, Beverly Hillbillies, like that kind of hillbilly music, I think it's great. It's real hard. do it right, you know. Put my Funny Valentine's on my. There we go. I think every style of music has a good, you know, somebody that really, really well in that style. Really, really good. You know, Chet Atkins is one of them. Can't think of a really good dirty joke right now. Dog licking his balls. You know that one. It's the old joke. Why does a dog lick his balls? Because he can. A lot of good rock players, too. Few, just like everything else, there's a handful of guys that are good jazz players, good rock players, good hillbilly guys, good bluegrass guys, I think. But there's only a handful. There's not very many in any every genre. Not really a handful, maybe 10. I don't really know, never counted them. Why does a lutus lick his fingers? Okay, David, I give up. Lutinist? So he doesn't slip on the G string. Blah. Here's a real foul one I heard. Now, nobody get offended, okay? So, you know, hey, you know something else? It's been all right. You know something? I think that everybody, you know, the world is so screwed up. Societies are all crazy and shit. I think people take themselves too seriously. You have to learn to laugh at yourself. You really do. You know, I laugh at my own ass. You know, I do stupid shit. You know, I can't take everything too serious. The difference between a bowling ball and a Polish girl? If you had to, you could eat the bowling ball. Nah, I got every Polish person. Here you go. Do you know how you know if an Italian airline is flying over ahead of you? The wings have hair underneath them. You guys need to eat 6 a.m. It's funny because it's true. Whoa. All right. Before I become politically incorrect, which is way too late for that. Yeah, the Bible does say laughter is good medicine. You know, whoa, rock and roller, he's Italian and Polish. Whoa. You know something? Here's another funny story. I laugh at myself. It was like, one of my first gigs right after Sleight of Hand came out, and I got to play with Paul Ballenbeck in Washington, D.C. The place was called One Step Down. It was like one of my first times playing Keep the Flies Off the Bride. I'm answering. Okay. Anyway, so the place was owned by a woman named Ann Mabuchi. Okay. So she was half Japanese and half Jewish, right? So me and my wisdom. So listen, nice to meet you. I says, if somebody calls you a Jap, do you get mad twice? Jewish American princess. And man, she says, the glasses, another one. Excuse me? Nah, never mind. No, tell me what you said. Well, you know, and you know, it's like you're half Japanese and half Jewish American princess. You know what I mean? She got it, and I explained it to her, and she went, do you know out of nowhere, will you play it for me? I said, well, shit, sure. So we played it. We played it at an up-tempo thing. And she went, I said, well, you know, do you like the tune? I hope it makes up for my bad joke. She says, it's a ballad. You guys fucked it all up, told me. But I thought from my, okay, never going to go back to there. But actually, she was really good about it. She hired me many times again after that. Trios, guitar duos, all things. All other things, difference between a Jew and a canoe. This is taking a bad turn. All right, I give up. Come on, Bob. A canoe tips. Oh, fuck. Jeez. Man, pretty far out. Okay. You know, what's funny about these live YouTube things, they stay there for a while. I'm afraid they ask one of Zappa's last compilation albums. It was called Have I Offended Anyone? Two titles, Jewish Princess and Catholic Girls. Yeah, you know, it takes all kind to make the world go round. And sometimes I think it's spinning the opposite way. Anyway, my message for today, learn to laugh at yourself. Don't take it too seriously. And I'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye.